Hello all. In this video, we will see how the withholding tax works in SAP. What exactly is a withholding tax? So if you are working in a company where the vendors are sending lot of invoices, right? So you are taking the services from the vendors and they are sending you the invoices. Now, if a vendor sends you the invoice of a specific amount, let's say the vendor sends you the invoice of 1000. According to the authorities, wherever withholding tax is applicable, if I take the example of India, in India, withholding tax is applicable, and before we pay to the vendor, we need to deduct the TDS, tax deducted at source, right? So if we are deducting that tax, then withholding tax becomes very important. You have to configure the withholding tax, you have to tell the system from which vendor you want to deduct the amount. And accordingly, whenever you will be processing the invoice of that vendor, system will automatically deduct some part and you need to pay the remaining amount to the vendor. Let me first show you the process. So what happens is when you receive the invoice from the vendor, let's say I'm creating an invoice using transaction FB60, which is a normal transaction. So even if you are receiving the invoices which are related to the goods, when you go to the transaction Miro, same process is applicable in case of Miro also. So here I will just enter a vendor. Okay, I'll enter the invoice date, whatever it is. Reference, I'm just entering. This is the system that I'm showing you today is 2020, which is the latest version of SAP S/4HANA. So I'll just enter the amount. And then normally when you process the withholding tax invoices, normally when you run the withholding tax related processes, in that case, these two fields are very important, business place and section code. So normally, if you are working in a company who have a lot of different locations, they must have having the different TAN numbers taken from the government. So whenever they are deducting any tax of a particular vendor, they need to show in that particular TAN. So for example, in our case, we have two separate, let's assume two separate TAN numbers, which we took, one for Bangalore and second for Pune. So we have to specify that this vendor is sending the invoice to which particular TAN and which TAN is responsible to deduct the amount of this vendor, right? Same goes for the section code also. So again, I created two separate section codes, one for Bengaluru and second for Pune. Okay, and let's assume I want to enter the GL account here. So I'm just processing the normal expense invoice. This is my amount. And since we are booking the expenses, we need to enter the cost center also. This is my cost center. Now, normally what happens is, if there is no TDS applicability, if you are processing the vendor invoice without any TDS deduction, then this entire 1000 amount, system will show that the liability is being booked to this particular vendor. But what will happen now, when a vendor is sending you the invoice of 1000, just assume there is 10% TDS applicable on this particular vendor, which means if an invoice is 1000, we need to deduct 10% and we need to pay the remaining amount to the vendor, which means the liability which will be created here is 900 and not 1000. Right? How it works? So let's try to simulate this transaction. You can see vendor is getting credited with only 900. The liability to the vendor is being booked only for 900. Now, what will happen to the remaining 10%? What will happen to this 100 which we are not paying to the vendor? This we have to pay directly to the tax authorities. Right? That is the reason you can see there is a GL account. I'll show you the entire setup. I'll show you where exactly this GL account is getting determined, how system knows that this particular vendor is entitled for TDS. So we will see all those things, but I'm just going in the backward direction so that you understand the process. So you have a vendor, I'm only booking the liability of 900, deducting 100 as TDS, and this TDS will be paid directly to the government, right? So this is a process of how exactly the TDS works in SAP. Now let's understand how exactly this end-to-end setup is done if TDS is applicable for a particular country. So there are many countries who are not following TDS concept, but there are some other countries like India, Brazil, there are a lot of countries actually. So I'll show you which are those countries in the country specific section. But there are some countries where TDS is applicable, and this setup what I'm going to show you today, this is the minimum requirement that you have to do in those countries where WHT is applicable. Right, so we will start with the scratch. As of now, I'm just clicking on post so that later on, if you want to generate the report on this particular transaction, we can see. So you can see this document number has been posted in this particular company code. Okay, so now let's go to the setup. So obviously, when it comes to setup in SAP, it is SPRO. All the configurations we do from SPRO. In SPRO, we have a separate folder for withholding tax, which comes under financial accounting. So you'll go to financial accounting global settings, and within this you can see a separate folder for withholding tax. So all the configurations related to withholding tax are done from this particular node. So let me open this withholding tax node and let's see some of the important. We are not going to discuss each and every activity, each and every field in this one, because that is something which will you will be doing when you know the exact scenarios. What I'm trying to show you is giving you just the idea of how exactly this basic setup is done in withholding tax. So here you have two separate folders, withholding tax and extended withholding tax, as the name itself suggests. So this covers the basic functionality and this covers some advanced functionalities which has evolved over the years. And normally, since this is having all the features of withholding tax plus additional features, normally we use extended withholding tax. Okay, let me open this. Now let's start with the basic settings. In basic settings, the first thing that you need to verify is whether your country is already listed in this withholding tax countries or not. So if your country doesn't exist, this means the system will not be able to process the withholding tax related transactions. So just verify that your country exists here. You can see our country in our example, I'm taking it is India. So you can see India is available here as the first entry itself, right? This is important. If this doesn't exist, then you cannot go further. Even if you do all the configurations, you may not be able to process the withholding tax related transactions. Okay, then you have defined the withholding tax keys. So you know, in India or maybe in another countries also, there are different type of withholding taxes. So there are different type of vendors. For example, when you are paying the rent, let's say your vendor is a person who is charging you some rent. So for rent, there is a separate rate applicability on TDS. It comes under the separate section, normally section 192. Similarly, if 192 is salary, 194I is for the rent. Similarly, there is 194C, which is normally for applicable for the vendors who are the contractors. So in the same way, there are different withholding tax keys which you can configure here. So whatever is applicable, when you are implementing SAP for the customer, you need to ask them in advance, what are those TDS applicabilities, what are those section codes under which you are going to deduct the tax from the vendors. Or in simple way, you can ask what are the different types of vendors from whom you are going to deduct the TDS. So they will provide you this list with the section codes. These are for country IN in my case. So as of now, I just configured 194C for contractors and 194I for rent. Similarly, 194 star, there are a lot of offsetting keys that you need to create here based on the business requirement. Okay, and you just need to provide the description so that it can be easily understood that this key is representing what. Okay, in my case, we have 194C and 194I. So the next few configurations I will show you on 194C, because even if you see the transaction that we have posted with the vendor who is applicable for this 194C, which means our vendor is nothing but our contractor. So let me come out. This reasons of exemption is only applicable when some of the vendors are exempted from the withholding tax. So normally what happens is there are some vendors who took the authority from the government that we please allow us that our vendors or our customers should not deduct our TDS, right? So in that particular case, if there are any such exemptions, you have to create those exemption reasons here. Okay, as of now, I just created one exemption region that it is just exempted from TDS. But if you have n number of exemption reasons, okay, whatever are provided by government, you can just create the two-digit code and you can provide the description. Okay, then recipient types, maybe I have not created, but I'll just tell you what are the recipient types. So normally when you go for withholding tax again, there are different segregations, whether a vendor is a registered company or it is a other than company or it is an individual. So that also you can create here. You can create those as a recipient types, and to each and every vendor you will be assigning whether it is a company or it is other than company or it is an individual. Right, so in my case, let me also show you parallelly what I have maintained for my vendor. So if I take you to my vendor, so you know in SAP S/4HANA, vendor is BP, business partner. I'm just opening my vendor. This is my vendor number. Let me double click here. And in the role, FLVN00, in company code data tab, you'll be able to see withholding tax. So you can see I have assigned the withholding tax type W1. I'll show you the setup of this. This is my withholding tax code, and I have told the system that this vendor is subject to withholding tax. Now here you can see I can enter the recipient type. So in this configuration, if I create some recipient types, if I create some recipient types here, whether it is a company or individual or other than company, that I can assign it. I can use them here when I'm setting up the vendor account. So that if in the report you want to segregate whether it is a company or others, you can easily get that report based on the vendor. Right, let's continue with our configuration. So recipient type, let's go back. If you want, I can just show you one example of recipient type. So what I'll do is I'll create new. Normally we create two in India. One is companies and second is other than companies, which is OT. Okay, if you want to provide the description, let's say this is companies. And this is others. Okay, let's save it. So now once it is available here, you can go to the vendor master data in the change mode. Currently you are in the display mode. Let me click on the change mode and you can assign the recipient type here. So whatever you create in that particular screen, it will be appearing here. Okay, so I created two companies and others. Let's close it. Let's go to the next configuration. So let me come out of this. Okay, other things, as I told you, you don't need to go in each and everything because whatever is applicable, I'm talking about only those activities. Now let's go to the India folder because this will give you the list of some configurations which are specific to India as a country. So if your legal entity belongs to India, if you are setting up the withholding tax for that company code which is set up in India, in that case only these configurations are relevant. Right, so first and very important one is business place. So if you remember when we process the transaction, let me again take you to the process transaction screen. So when I process the transaction, when I go to transaction FB60, see, this is where system is asking you the business place and section code. So as I told you, if your company is having different TAN numbers, in that case you need to create different business place and section codes. Okay, so in our case, in our example, I told you we have two locations, two TAN numbers, one for Bangalore, second for Pune. So in that case, I have to create two different business places from here. Okay, so and that is company code specific. So you have to create the business places at the company code level. In my example, this is my company code and I should be able to see two different business places which I have created here. Tomorrow, if I'm taking another TAN number, then again, I need to come here and I need to create a separate business place for that particular TAN number registration. Okay, let's come out. Same way, go to the section code. This is where you will be able to create the section code also. Again, it is based on the company code. So 1:1 normally, the same that you have created as business place, you need to create it as a section code. Let's come out. Okay, and other important things like if you want to maintain the TAN numbers, so in this particular screen, section code, TAN and CIT address, you can mention that, okay, Bangalore is having this TAN number and Pune is having this TAN number. Okay, so that if you want to print this during the invoices or during the challans, you can print the TAN number from here. It is getting captured here. Okay, so these are the important setups. Nothing more important here. Let me go out of basic settings and go to the calculation now. In the calculation, there are two important folders, withholding tax type and withholding tax code. Okay, so now in withholding tax type, again you can see two important things. Define the withholding tax types for invoice posting and define the tax withholding tax types for payment posting. So you know, at least in India, other countries we need to find out. In India, the withholding tax is applicable on the invoice or on the payment, whichever is earlier. So if you are getting an invoice from the vendor and then you are making the payment, so withholding will be deducted at the time of invoice. But sometimes if you are paying the advance to the vendor and then receiving the invoice, so for that advance that you have paid, even there itself, you need to deduct the TDS. And that is the reason in India, as I told you, the TDS is applicable either at the time of invoice or at the time of payment. So for setting up the TDS or withholding tax at the time of invoice, we need to create a tax type here. And for payment, we need to set up here if required. So in our example, I'm just going to this invoice related posting. Again, it is asking you for a particular country. So whatever withholding tax keys or codes you create, those are at the country level. Right? So you cannot use a withholding tax which is created for one country in another one. You have to create separately for each country. Now here you can see, this is my withholding tax type. Okay, 2-digit code, whatever you want to provide the coding, that is up to you. I just provided W1 and I'm just saying this is TDS applicable at the time of invoice. Okay, and then there are some basic settings, like for example, the TDS is applicable on what amount? Is it applicable before tax or it is applicable after tax? Okay, so based on your settings, based on the country levels, you need to either tell the system it is based on the net amount or it is based on the gross amount. Okay, so normally if you ask me in India we follow this gross amount concept. The rounding rule. You know rounding, like for example, if the amount, the TDS amount is having multiple decimals and if you want to round off it to only 2 decimals, so what should we do? Whether we should round it up or round it down or use the commercial round. Commercial round means if it is less than 4 or less than 4, it would be rounded down. But if it is more than 5 or more than 5, then it will be rounded up to the next one, which is round up. Okay, similarly, this is very important. You have to tick on this indicator, otherwise the system will not be able to post your withholding tax. So this you have to use, and other settings are again dependent on the different business requirements. So normally we follow the standard whatever is provided, but if there is additional requirement that your customer is giving you, you can come here and you can change it accordingly. Okay, let's go back. Same way, I have created one withholding tax type for the payment also. So it will look a copy of what we have seen in case of invoice. Okay, only the difference is I provided a new tax type. Otherwise, you can see most of the things are exactly same. Okay, some additional fields, but those are only relevant to the payment, not to the invoice. Let's go back. These are optional settings. Define the exchange rate type for withholding tax type. For example, in SAP, normally for day-to-day transactions, we follow exchange rate type M, which means whenever we are posting any transaction in foreign currency, in order for the system to convert that foreign currency into the local currency, system requires a exchange rate. And we can maintain different exchange rates, okay, based on different exchange rate types. So normally the exchange rate type that we use for our day-to-day transactions is exchange rate type M. Only in case when you want to have a separate rate, when you don't want to use exchange rate M, if you want to use a separate rate for TDS calculation, only in those cases you need to provide the exchange rate type here. Otherwise, normally we keep this blank. Okay, and then let me close this. Let's go to the withholding tax codes. So similar to withholding tax type, we have to create the withholding tax code, and this is exactly where we tell the system how much percentage is applicable for a particular withholding tax code. So here I created the withholding tax code. You can see withholding tax code W1, which is TDS on contractors and which is assigned to the section 194C. If you remember, I told you based on the types of vendors, you may need to create the different section keys. Okay, and whenever you are creating the withholding tax code, you have to tell the system that this withholding tax code is related to which section. Okay, so in our case, we are saying withholding tax code W1 is for the vendors who are the contractors. Okay, and you can provide the description, and this is where you are telling the system whether the entire gross amount is subject to tax or only the percentage of amount is subject to tax. So by default, it is 100%. Normally we follow 100%. And this is where you are telling the system the rate. So what is the rate of the TDS? In our example, we posted the document of 1000, 100 was calculated as the withholding tax. How? Based on this calculation. If I maintain 5 here, then what will happen? The system will calculate the TDS as 50, not 100. Okay, so based on what rate is applicable, you can come here and you can change it, right? Let's go out from here also. So we have created the withholding tax type. We have created a withholding tax code. What is the next one? The next one is, let me come out of this calculation. Let's go to company code. In company code, these are the two important settings. If you create a withholding tax type and you don't assign that withholding tax type to your company code, in that case, that withholding tax type cannot be used in your company code. So we have to create a combination here. We have to tell the system in XYIN company code, which are those tax types that you are going to use. In my example, I just created one, but if there are N number of withholding tax types that you have created for different type of vendors, you have to enter all those things here and assign it to company code. So for example, if I created W2 tomorrow, but I forgot to maintain this configuration, then I will not be able to use that W2 for this company code. Okay, so this is another important thing. Lastly, you have to activate the withholding tax for a particular country. So how the system will know? Let's assume there is one country where withholding tax is not applicable till today. And now suddenly they introduce the withholding tax. In that particular case, you have to come here and you have to tell the system that for this company code, withholding tax is applicable, and for which company code, withholding tax is not applicable. Okay, so based on the country, normally withholding tax is applicable, but this is where you can set up the extended withholding tax code based on the company codes. So just verify that it is applicable for our company, which we are using in our scenario. So for XYIN, we can see extended withholding tax is applicable, activated. Okay, so these are the basic settings. The last folder that you need to see from the withholding tax code point of view is posting. Now definitely, what happened here, if you see our posting that we have made, okay, if I show you this posted document display, so system was able to calculate the amount, how much amount you need to deduct from the vendor. And then it was also able to post in a particular GL. This is a GL master data, right? How system derived this GL? How system know that my tax portion should go to this GL and not to some other GL? So that is something which you do through the account determination. Okay, in order to determine the account, you have to set up this configuration, accounts for withholding tax. So this is where you will use this particular activity called as define accounts for withholding tax to be paid over. Just open this, enter your chart of account. So in my case, my chart of account is XYZ. So here you can see, based on different withholding tax codes, I can set up a different GL accounts. So in this example, as I told you, the withholding tax code is assigned to this particular GL, and that is the reason you can see the posting has happened to this GL. It is the same GL what you assigned here. So if you have different withholding tax codes and you want to assign them to different GLs, you can just keep on adding here different withholding taxes codes types and codes, and then assign the GL accounts here. Okay, so this is regarding the posting. This was the last activity. Now, in order to tell the system that which vendor is subject to withholding tax and which vendor is not subject to withholding tax, although I've shown you already that particular activity, you have to go to the vendor master data. And in vendor master data, under the company code tab, you will see vendor withholding tax related tab. So what you need to do here is you need to tell the system if the withholding tax is applicable for this vendor. You have to enter the withholding tax type, you have to enter the withholding tax code, and this tick will tell the system that withholding tax is applicable for this vendor. Okay, I've shown you if you want to add the recipient type, whether this is a company or others, if you want to enter the exemption number, if the vendor has told you, please don't deduct my TDS, I have the authority from the government, then you can enter the exemption reason also here, which we have set up previously. So as of now, we only set up one exemption reason. You can write n number of exemption reasons, whatever are provided by the government, and you can select it over here. Right, so this is the overall configuration. This is where you maintain the master data. And then once all these things are done, you can try one scenario using transaction FB60, where you just enter the vendor number. Just ensure that the vendor that you are using in the master data, you have activated the withholding tax tab for this vendor. Okay, enter your invoice date, the reference, whatever is the amount. And this is important from the reporting point of view, even though by default, if you keep it blank, it will not stop you, but this is wrong because otherwise your reports will not appear correctly. So normally in the companies where we work, they ask us to make those fields mandatory, and we normally make them mandatory through different validations. Right, so this is my GL, expense GL. This is again the same amount which I entered over here. And since it is an expense, I have to provide some cost object. In my case, I am providing the cost center. So now if you simulate, you can see TDS payable is getting calculated 10%, and this 10% is getting posted to this particular GL, which you can map to the account determination. Okay, and once if you feel that this posting is correct, you will click on post. And now the final thing, that whatever process we follow, ultimately we have the objective of, there is only one objective to follow all this process to get the reports. So one report which will help you in getting the end-to-end picture regarding the withholding tax, although there are the reports might be required in different format. SAP provides some standard reports also. If not, you may need to create your own report in the required format which is given to you by the business. But one report which will give you good amount of information and you can convince the client that go for this is J1 INEMIS. J1 INEMIS. Okay, so just remember J1 INEMIS was available earlier, but now if you don't write this E, you will not be able to use the old report. Old report is no more available, it has been replaced with a new report. Right, you can enter your company code here for which you want to generate a report, the fiscal year, section code which we have created. So if you want to generate a report for Bangalore, or you want to report generate the report for Pune, that you can specify here. Again, whether you want to generate the report for 194C or 194I, that you can provide it here. Okay, so I want to generate for 194C. And then you need to specify the month for which you want to generate this report. So I want to generate for April month. Currently, you can do it from F4. So it will give you the list of all the months. April. If you want to specify a vendor that I am generating only for this particular vendor, or you can keep a list of vendors, you can also say 1 to ZZZ, which means all the vendors will be considered by default. Okay, let's try to execute this report now. You can see you are getting the complete information that this accounting document with this reference number, this document type, the posting date, document date with official withholding key is applicable, what is the section code, who is the vendor, what tax type, which tax code, okay, what is the tax rate, what is the base amount, and how much is the tax amount. So this report will give you the end-to-end picture. This will also help you in generating your legal reporting in case of TDS. But as I told you, in addition to this, in different countries, we have different reports which are required to be filed with the government according to their template. So I hope you like this video. I hope this will help you in setting up the withholding tax in your companies. If you are facing any issues, please comment us in the comment box and we will definitely try to help you out. Thank you all for watching this video and see you in the next video. Bye.